Hello friends, what's up? Welcome back to my channel. If you are new to my channel, I'm Akanksha. So in this video we are going to talk about foundation. I had no idea what I was going to film, okay, basically. So I went back to my old videos to get some inspiration, and I did this one video almost two years ago. If it's like October, it's almost 2 years ago, that when I reviewed like 10 foundations together, so that you'll have like a list of, in one place, of my shade, what I think about them and stuff. And I had to do a part two and I never did, so I'm like, here I am. All the 10 foundations of course are different from the previous video, and I also had a moment watching that video that how far I've come in terms of a lot, in terms of my setup, me, my skin, everything together. Like I just had a moment. I'll link that video right here. You can check out those foundations as well, like what my opinion on those foundations are. But today I have 10 different foundations again, from drugstore to high end, and you liked it last time, so I thought I'll make a second version, so that again you have my opinion on the foundation, you'll have my shade reference of the foundation as well. I really hope I can get through this video because my voice something is wrong with it since the past like 4-5 days, and it's just like whenever I'm talking a lot I start coughing also so much. But anyway, I also again long intro, but yeah, let's get started. Yeah. If you want to shop any of the foundations I'm talking about, I will leave all the links in the description box. You can definitely check it out. So when I'm reviewing the foundation, there's going to be 4 points I'm going to talk about. One is the coverage, the finish, the skin type which it'll suit, and my shade in it. The same like last time how I did in that video. So let's start off. I am going to start off with an affordable one, which is the Mamaearth Glow Serum Foundation. This one I actually even made a review on it. So if you want like a full-fledged video of what I think about this foundation, then you can definitely check it out. This is generally for people, I would say, more towards normal dry skin, not really for oily skin. It does say it's a glow serum foundation, so it does, you know, I think the claim behind it is it for it to be like a serum, like a skin, a good product also, but also which has a little bit of pigment, which is also for like, you know, makeup. So basically it's a skin tint. So the coverage is also very like sheer to medium. If you do build on, you can get a little bit of coverage, but once you build on, it's not as good as it would be with just one layer. Like even for the first layer, it's a very average foundation. Like for me, nothing exceptional about it. But if you do want like some everyday kind of foundation, then you can definitely go with this. But I don't know if they have more shades, but when I reviewed it, they had like a really shitty shade range for such a big brand. Again, if you want like, you know, to see the total review, you can check it out right here. So the shade range is not that great, so you will the deeper skin tones will not get their foundation shade whatsoever. Medium skin or lighter skin, you can ignore my hair, you guys. I'm trying to not put heat on it, so I just like washed my hair. I tried to do something and I put it in a ponytail because like I have a lot of heat damage on my hair because of the amount of styling I do and like the amount of times I do. But coming back to the foundation, it's in between. It's not like really good and it's not like bad, so it's in between. And I generally like don't support the brand and all, but you know, I know it's a foundation, a commonly available foundation, and people want to know my opinion. So this is the first one. So I have the shade Almond Glow. It is a little lighter on my skin, but it's the best they have, so it is what it is. So the next one is the Huda Beauty 4 Filter Foundation. Ignore that it is dirty. I use this one a lot, and this is in the shade Trey Liche 320G. I really like this one. I hope that's how Trey Liche is performed. I'm trying my best, okay? But yeah, so this is our second version of this foundation. If you don't know, the first version they basically launched, I really wanted to try a Huda Beauty foundation because all the products I've tried before that were really, really nice. But then they had like a lot of fragrance, extreme like comedogenic ingredients and stuff like that, so I never invested in that. But they did hear their customers and they launched a second version of it, which is again, now this one has no fragrance, no comedogenic ingredients, it's non-comedogenic and stuff. So I was like, like, okay, this one I'm trying. So finish wise, it's more on that demi matte matte side. So if you have dry skin, you'll really have to like properly prep your skin, or else you might feel a little dry. Coverage wise, this is not for a faint heart. It is a full glam, like a glam kind of foundation. So it's a medium to full coverage foundation, and you will know that it is on, but once it's on, it's beautiful. Now, like I told you, this is a little matte, right? So I kind of mix a little of my NARS, which is a little a glowy side, so kind of balances it out. But by itself also, it's really nice if you prep your skin well. That is an important step. You need to hydrate your skin enough. It photographs so well. Like this foundation, like you have festive season coming, your wedding season coming, if you want to be in front of camera, then this is the foundation to go for. I don't know what is there in this, but the way it like, it's just beautiful, like especially even flash photography. I'll put like 1-2 images here of when I wore this foundation and how flawless my skin looked even in flash photography. Usually flash photography is like, I'm a little scared, but then, you know, this just like looked stunning, and I really like this one. So yeah, like if you want to invest in a good high, full glam kind of luxury foundation, then you can invest in this one. Again, non-comedogenic, so even acne prone skin can use it. Moving on to the next one, which is the Lakme 95 Primer Plus Matte Foundation. Now this is in the shade Cool Cinnamon. So like initially I tried a shade before this and it was a little light on it, but this one kind of suits, it's kind of close to my skin. So I did not get this one initially because it says Cool Cinnamon and I thought it'll be like, you know, pinkier on my skin, and most of my foundations are like, you know, inclined towards yellow tones, because obviously I have like a major yellow undertone, if you can't already tell in my face. So but I was like, that is not fine, and the next one is too dark. So I tried this one and this one does match me. So this is Cool Cinnamon C300, and it's not cool at all. Like I don't think it's like pink or anything. It suits me well. So this one, I think, is probably the first foundation from Lakme that I really really liked. So coming to the finish, it is demi matte finish. It's not too glowy, not too matte, so all skin types can use this one. And third, it is medium to full coverage, so you can keep it a little sheer and natural if you want, but you can build it up and make it full glam as well. It does last for a really really long time. I've tried it for like 7-8 hours one day when I was going out, and it did hold up, and I really like this one. So good affordable foundation, and Lakme did come up with a wider shade range with this launch, which I am so happy about. It's not like the best shade range, but it's definitely out there, and they have improved from before. So I think you can definitely find your shade in it. Moving on to the next one, which is the Rare Beauty foundation, and I'm in the shade 310 W. Now this one, initially when I used this foundation, I think I liked it, but I was like, okay, like nothing exceptional about it, like, you know, or something like that. But like whenever I keep using it again and again, I really like the finish it gives. It just, like, even though it does cover up marks and does everything, it just gives a really nice skin like finish to the skin, which I really like. Coming to the finish, it is a little on a dewy side. Coming to skin type, all skin types can use it, but oily people do have to use a little more powder. Coming to the coverage, it can be sheer, it can be medium, and it can be full. If you layer it on, it does, like, you know, get to full glam, but I would not recommend that, because I feel like this foundation is good for it to be like really lightweight and skin like. So this foundation I would suggest, especially if you're somebody like, you know, you want an everyday foundation for college, for office, something very light and stuff like that, then you can definitely try this one. Next up, we have the Nykaa All Day Matte Foundation. When this foundation launched, I was so excited to try it, and I did, and I ended up not liking it. I was so excited for this one to work, but unfortunately it did not work for me. So for me, like, starting off only, I'm saying this is not a foundation I am a fan of. Initially when you apply it, it's beautiful, but like throughout the day, it just does not survive, especially because it says it's all day matte, but it does not agree to that claim in any way. It does get oily throughout the day, it kind of balls up as well. So like for me, it was a big, you know, like miss. But finish wise, it is initially it is a very, like, you know, demi matte one. Again, it's not like extremely matte or something. And second, coverage wise, it does have pretty good coverage, which I really like. It does not cling on to dry patches. It goes on beautifully. So that's the reason I was very excited. But like throughout the day, it did not last well for me. That was my main issue. So for skin type, they say it's for normal to combination skin, and I have combination to oily skin. So, and I did get oily throughout the day after doing touch-ups as well. So I think it'll be good for, like, you know, normal skin if you want it to last like throughout the day. But for extremely oily skin, it might not work. And I'm in the shade Mocha 11, which is again lighter to me and a little too neutral. The next one was a little way too warm and way too dark. So again, in this foundation also, the shade range is not that great. Then moving on, next I have the Too Faced Born This Way foundation, and this is in the shade Sand. Sand shade matches me perfectly. It is a tiny bit warm, but I really don't mind. I love the finish it does give on my skin. Again, coming to the coverage, it is again a very glam kind of foundation, but it does not look glam. Like, the Huda Beauty is glam and looks glam, but, like, you know, good glam, not like a bad glam. This one, you can make it look like you know, a little matched, a little bit, not, you know, obviously a lot, because it is like a full glam foundation. So for in terms of coverage, it can be medium to full coverage. The finish is a very, like, demi matte finish, which I again think suits with most of the skin types, no matter what, dry, oily, normal. Everybody can try this foundation, and I'm in the shade Sand, and I really like this one. I don't have much to say about it. I just have good things to say, like all the good things which you say about a foundation. So you can definitely try this one out also. If you do not like the Huda Beauty one, then, and if you have a little more drier skin, you can also try this option, because this one suits everybody. Huda Beauty, you need a little more prep, like I told you. So again, a beautiful foundation. I tried this one very late, like years after it launched. I don't know why I waited so much, and I regretted it when I used it for the first time. So, like, yeah, love this one. Moving on to the next one. Next for Rockstore, I have the NYX Can't Stop Won't Stop foundation. This foundation from Rockstore, one of my favorite, suits all skin types according to me. The finish is medium to full coverage, and it looks stunning. Like, it does not cling on to dye patches, it does not you know, ball up. It just looks so flawless, so smooth on the skin. It glides on, blends beautifully. And third, and finish is in between. It's not as matte as demi matte, but it's not very dewy as well. It's in, like, between, I feel, which is the perfect balance. I don't know what is the word for it. If there's a word for it, let me know. But yeah, this is foundation which is in between, which can be suited for, like, dry skin as well, and it'll be, like, you know, okay for oily skin as well. And it does last throughout the day. They have, like, a wide shade range in this foundation as well. I'm in the shade Classic Tan. Initially when I apply, it looks a little lighter, but once blended into the skin, beautiful. That this is the foundation I applied on my skin today as well. You can see how cute, how nice it looks. Like, the finish, love it. Then next up, all I have now are Drugstore foundations only. The next one I have is the K Beauty Hydrating Foundation. Now, this is the only foundation I don't have a shade reference for you guys, unfortunately, like a swatch, because I was filming a video the other day and I broke the bottle and I don't have it anymore. But my shade in that was medium 145N. So finish wise, it does say it's a hydrating foundation, and it does do that. It is more on a dewy side. So, and coverage wise, it is sheer to medium coverage foundation. It gives a very skin like finish, looks beautiful. Like, again, a really nice one for, like, an everyday use. And skin type, unfortunately, this only dry skin or normal skin can use. Combination oily skin cannot use, because it is on the dewy end. So if we do use that, we kind of will end up get oily really quickly. You can definitely use it. It's not like you can't, but of course you have to, like, use a mattifying primer, a mattifying powder, stuff like that, so that the dewiness of the foundation is balanced out. But other than that, like, the foundation is stunning. I really like this one. It gives a beautiful finish. Next one. Now, this foundation I love so much, but they have such bad shade range, which unfortunately sucks. Foundation I'm talking about is the Inside Cosmetics HD foundation. This is one of the most nicest affordable foundations I've tried. They have such bad shade range. I think they just have 6 shades, so not everybody can find their shade, unfortunately. Finish wise, it's a demi matte foundation. Coverage wise, medium to full coverage. It's skin type, I feel most of the skin types can use it. And shade wise, I have MN30, but I have to mix this one with another lighter foundation because I have another shade as well, which is 35, which is again a little more darker than this. And this I thought will be a lighter on me, but this is a tad bit dark. You can see on the swatch like how dark it is. So I do have to mix a little bit of it. And this one oxidizes a lot as well. Like in all the foundations I've showed, everything oxidizes like teeny tiny bit. I feel all foundations do, but like extreme oxidization happens with this foundation, and so you have to be careful. Like I think next time now I really want to buy this one, and they have MN20, which I think I'm going to buy that, because even in the concealer I have that MN Y20, so I think foundation also I'll go with that one, which I really like. So this foundation, beautiful. If you are looking for an affordable good one, if you can find your right shade, then definitely go with this one. I really like it. Then last but not the least is the Miss Claire Everyday Foundation. Now this foundation is on a miss or like a fail category for me, because I wanted to like it, you guys. I really did. But it just like the finish it gave, like, you know, this one is affordable, but it just like sinks into the skin, gives such a beautiful finish, like how any foundation is supposed to. This one I feel like kind of sat on top of my skin and did not really, like, you know, give me like that vibe of a foundation I really like. Look at me talking about a vibe with a foundation, like, anyways, but yeah, that is what it is. And then that it's a medium to full coverage, a demi matte finish, skin type I think works across all the skin types. I'm in the shade neutral buff, again a very shitty shade range, but yeah, I think that wraps it up. Those are the 10 foundations. I'm so glad my voice is not gone, and I'm so glad I do not cough a lot. But yeah, we went through 10 foundations, and those are my opinions on these 10 foundations. I hope it is useful. Let me know if any other foundations you have in mind which you want me to, like, you know, review. I would love to do that for you guys. Comment down below. So that's about it for the video, you guys. And this video shout out goes to Pratyusha. Thank you, Pratyusha, for always loving and supporting. It absolutely means the world to me. If you want to be part of next video shout out, and all you have to do is comment below and use the hashtag AKS, and you can be a part. If you like this video, then make sure like, share and subscribe to my channel, ring the notification bell, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.